stop breathing because you start training in utilizing weapons. So that's what we'll kind of focus on today. So we will start with just some loosening up, okay? Always good to add stretching to your training, not just jump right into things. As you can see, I'm starting with the Joe. Try to breathe in through your nose, all the way down to your tongue. And then exhale. And some figure eights. Just relaxing, back up. Sides, back of your head. Okay, I'm going to try and keep our shoulders relaxed. So let's just begin one-handed with the Joe, standing in Hanmi, okay? So making sure that we're lined up with the middle, again, the middle of our back foot, not our heel, not our toes, not our heel, okay? So you can bring your feet together. This isn't a very good posture for stability. You'll see as you slide your foot out, that feels a little better. And then again, we're bending our knee over the front foot, okay? So, let's just put the Joe in our hand at the middle, work on this flexibility. Back to this posture, just standing sort of like in a horse stance, right? And let's just create some circles here. The center of your figure eight, right at your center. So, center of the Joe, switch to Hanmi, left hand, left foot. So, as you're doing this exercise, you have to think about the strikes that they represent. So, one of them is back this way. Then forward. This forward one again is like Aikido. Right? So forward and back. And you have to let it roll and rotate in your hand, flexible. And other side, right hand knee, Joe, continuing to look like that figure eight, right? You don't have to go fast. Again, you save it right in the middle, okay? So over the top, as you turn your hand, the hands come together, then they switch position. Okay, show you that from the side. So here, as we turn, keep pushing with your thumb so you get a little bit more of a turn, okay? As you get a little bit better at this, you can speed it up a little bit. That's not so important. It's more developing your form, okay? So the Joe and the Boken are somewhat similar. The strikes, that is. And again, we practice the strikes with weapons to develop extension, projection, but also to inform and to help us develop our body movements, right? So all of these movements can be done just with your hands, right? Well, that's an easy thing to do. You can begin to see that and relate these things. Okay, so the Joe is a little different than the Boken. Typically adopt a right-handed swordsman. So the right hand is forward for the Boken. But with the Joe, we can switch hands. We don't have to worry about the cutting edge. So keep that in mind. You want to be working on both sides of your body as you start to learn how to strike. Okay, so you know from your body art that, and many of you we've tested as children and adults, so we have motions, ski, back and forth, right? Do that all the time. So we have a ski strike, then we have shomen, it's a straight cut down the center. And that's with the suriyashi, which means sliding foot, right? Then we also have a angled cut, that's called yokomen, and that's with the step of the back foot. And we establish our footwork, but we're not just moving like this, okay? We keep our head protected, we step in, we're prepared to strike. Right, so we do these things in terms of body art. You can practice forward and back, right? In way, in position, changing feet. Again, skis with a step. Shomen, sliding step, right? Suryashi. Yumiyashi is sort of a walking step. So in order to do that with the Joe, there's actually two ways to hold the Joe. You can either hold it junte, free, means your hand is open, or you can do gyakute, which is like the kaishi ski. So, and all that means is opposite. Junte, this is kaishi, so either hand open or thumb on the top. So we're gonna do ski from, there's actually three of them, but we'll do it with open hand right now, okay? So I wanna be relaxed. I don't wanna reach down too far. My shoulder will follow my whole posture. I don't wanna bring my shoulder up. So whatever this is naturally, just let your and keep that basic little bend that we like to have, the way we stand in Aikido, the way we roll, so all the same kind of motions. We don't want to have our arms going all over the place, okay? So let's just let this weapon stand right in front of us, right? And we just draw it through our hand, right? So I'm grabbing this one with my my thumb down, this one with open hand, and I just pull this right through my hand, okay? Then I slide and I push it through. I don't want to go out too far. I don't want to be on the wrong side of my body. I actually go all the way across my body. You see that? One hand is up, one hand is down, okay? And I just do this kind of thing. You know, if I were outside, I might not want to drag it on asphalt. I might just keep it a little bit, then place it here. But we do want to start with a weapon in front of us, right? You can see there's an opening here, and there's an opening there. So why not centralize this, okay? Right on your belt, okay? So pull this through, slide, and twist it. See, I'm staying on that line, okay? So we'll show you other skis going forward, right? I said there's three of them. But for today, we'll just do this, and we'll do our basic other two strikes too, okay? So we'll do sort of five on each side, then we switch. Remember, it's going to be with right foot forward, then its right hand is lower, right? I don't want to be like this. It's not going to be very helpful to me. But we are constantly changing our feet, so this is, again, very basic, right? Bring this right by my ear, and I let it run through my hand. My hand sort of points in the direction that I want to strike. So I don't want to end like this. I want to end lined up with the mats. Right? That's why I like our mats, because we can utilize them for making sure our posture. Sometimes we want to be off the line. Sometimes we want to be right on the line. And when we're practicing our strikes, we want to stay right on the lines. Here. So this is ski. Again, we're using suryasana, sliding foot, right? Back to this side one more time, here. You're gonna find one side is a little more comfortable in many cases. It's not always because, hey, I'm a righty or I'm a lefty. I'm a lefty. I like the fact that Aikido has taught me to utilize both of my hands pretty much equally. Okay, so that's ski, and that's something that you can work on. Next one is going to be shomen, and we'll do that as an exercise too. Okay, so what I'm going to do is do a strike with ski, right? Just like you've been doing. Now I'm going to slide back and take the weapon through my backhand, then all the way through to the top of my head, back to the line, and change feet, okay? So let's stay on the left side for a moment. When we finally get a little bit further with this, we'll do both sides, okay? So here's the ski, right? Then we slide back. So you need a little bit of space to do this, right? The confusing thing is when the hands start to come together. By now, you start to twist your hand a little bit and strike. Back to left foot. Again, jute, open hand, strike. Let it come back, your body first, then you start pulling the jute, then you push the jute with your forward hand. Push, bring it to the top of your head, and strike. We'll let you choke up a little won't feel so heavy. All right, right side. Again, junte, back. Make sure you have enough room, front and back. Draw this through, strike, pull the back hand. When you reach the end of it, push, right? Top of your head, and strike. So we end up switching sides when we do it, right? Here. Slide back, push. Now, you know, depending on where I am, I could just step back and strike, right? Or I can slide and step forward. So, you know, for now, I think it makes the most sense to do both sides. So ski, here, and step. Then we can kind of stay in the same position. It won't take up as much space, which is important if you have a lot of people training. And I don't know how many of you are out there right now, but don't get in the way of each other. Step and strike. So you can leave the ski out and just keep going back and forth. And sometimes that helps people understand this movement a little easier. Again, you can choke up if the ceilings are low. There's a bunch of trees you don't want to hit. Slide. Back, strike, pull, push, step, pull, push, step, pull, push, step. So do I have to tell you what this strike is? And we're doing it with a step, right? Not just a slide. It's a basic ski, right? The first one was basic ski. And now, shomen. Right? So normally we do shomen with a slide, but in an exercise we're doing it this way, right? So I just start it, create some motion, step, and strike. Okay, so the last one for today is going to be yokomen. Yokomen is a step and an angle strike. Right, so I always want to bring my hand to the top of my head and strike. Right, top of my head and strike. So the same thing. Now what we do in this case, this one's a little difficult because you really need to change your hand to make it seem like you do it with body art. Okay. So we're going to just bring the weapon up, and this is a cover, right? And that's the same thing as bringing your hand up. You can see me protecting the top of my head, all right? Then I'm going to step and change hands. Again, this one takes a little bit extra practice, right? So, cover. Start to spin the jo as the feet come together. Finish your step and an angle cut. Then back down, right here. Cover, here. See the jo starting to come up and an angle strike right here. Aiming for where the neck and the shoulder come together. All right? So we're doing it from junte again, all right? What does junte mean? My hand is open or free, okay? I cover, that's just bringing the weapon up. By the time my foot starts coming forward, it's already starting to tip. That was on the ground, it's going to the top, and my hands are going to change and finish the strike. Okay, cover. Not everybody is just beginning defensive posture before I finish my step. Back in. So cover, step, strike, draw back, in. Pulling, pushing, and strike. Sides, a couple of times, here, elbow, strike, left, we'll push the jaw, your head, in, back, strike again, cover, strike, pull, push, showman. Starting, okay. Pull, push, strike. Cover, pull, pull. Down. Back, cover. Okay, so that's going to be it today. Just give you again couple of things that you can work on. We'll be going between the sword and the staff. Remember, you can always get a large dowel or a small broomstick. If you're a smaller person, you can start to feel comfortable. When you can always borrow a weapon at the dojo, and soon we may actually be having some outdoor classes, which will allow us to do this live and not Memorex, as they say. Seeing me here at the dojo is not as much fun as me being there live, I can assure you. So this is hard for all of us, so please give it a try, and then let us know whether you're moving too fast, you're talking too much, I missed something, could you explain any of those questions? We're looking forward to hearing from you. Okay, so we'll bow out now. Very much.